Hi there, this month I'm joined by Pasha. Say hi, Pasha.
Hello.
Yeah. We're going to be looking at some changes of state. These demonstrations I usually do with lower year groups when first introducing the particle theory, but research into student teachers' flawed mental models for what's going on inside a tube like this, for example, suggests that returning to these demonstrations with older students is also worthwhile. So let's jump in. In this clip, we'll be looking at the difference between boiling and evaporation. Let's start off with some hot water. If I just sort of pour some hot water out here. Pasha, can you confirm for the audience on the video what the temperature is of this water?
74 degrees Celsius.
Okay, so about 74. We're well away from the temperature it was at just before we sort of poured it out from the kettle. What would you now say if you were describing to the audience at home what's happening here in terms of states of matter, like solids, liquids, gases? What's going on?
It's a very hot liquid that produces a little bit of steam.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything happening to the liquid right now, do you think?
It's cooling down.
Okay, for
sure. As we speak.
And where is that energy going?
Into the air and into the surrounding area.
Yeah, okay. Is there any boiling or evaporation taking place here?
Yeah, evaporation. I guess, some evaporation is taking place.
Yeah, okay. What makes you say that?
Because I can see the steam going from the beaker.
Okay, we can see something coming off from that beaker that suggests it's going, maybe there's some evaporation.
Also, there is some steam on the side of the beaker.
Yeah, nice. Okay. Would you describe this liquid as boiling right now?
No.
Okay, that's totally fair as well. Okay, so we've got a liquid in here that's quite hot, over 70 degrees Celsius. We would agree that it's evaporating but not boiling.
Yeah.
So my next thing would be to say to you, what would be some of the things that I could do to make this liquid boil?
Heat it up again.
Okay, so I could put it back into the kettle, turn on the kettle, and eventually, of course, it would boil. Would there be any other things that I could do to that liquid to get it boiling without actually heating it up?
I don't know.
Yeah, okay, well, let's find out. So what we're gonna do, we need this water to be sort of over 70. It was sort of over 70 there, but we'll just give it a little bit of a warm up to make sure it's well in that zone. And then pop that on for a second there. And while that is heating up, I would normally do this part separately, but I'm going to place a couple of anti-bumping granules into the bottom of this syringe here. Okay. So now we can see perhaps there's, you know, some bubbles here. We want this to cool down so that it's sort of well away from the boiling temperature. We'll plonk the thermometer in there. And what I'll do in a moment is I'm gonna draw up some of the liquids into here, up to about the 20 centimeter cube mark. This is a 60 centimeter cube plastic syringe. And then I've got a syringe cap here as well. Super, okay, so our water is just getting back down to 80 degrees Celsius again. Now, I deliberately didn't have this conversation with you while the kettle was running because it would have been too loud, but what were you hearing when the kettle was sort of was heating up that water again?
I was hearing an increase in the pitch of the sound, and then at some point, the sound started to fade away.
Yeah, okay, so like there was a loud sound and then it started to get a little bit quieter. Did you see anything inside the kettle?
Well, the bubbles were forming and popping over.
For sure, there were sort of bubbles forming and popping. Now, here's the trick, like, what was in those bubbles?
Air.
Air? Okay. Anything else?
Water?
Yeah, maybe. Let's sort of see if we can sort of, so we've got an idea about what's going on. Our temperature now, by the way, is sort of just down to 77 degrees. Now, because a lot of people might think that there would be air inside those bubbles, that's one of the reasons for showing this the other way around. So I'm gonna tilt this away from you as I'm rotating it so I don't spray you in the face with some hot water. And I'm now going to squeeze out all of the air from this syringe. Would you be happy to say there's no air inside this syringe right now?
Yeah.
Yeah. I put the cap on. Okay. And now I'm going to draw the plunger back, and I want you to tell the audience what you see. Did you see that?
Bubbles forming.
Bubbles forming. Okay. Now, in this case, again, you might say, well, wait a minute. There was no air in that syringe beforehand. Let's just sort of confirm again. We'll squeeze out. There's no air present. And then when I suck this back.
Yeah, bubbles forming again.
What could be in the bubbles? Because there was no air inside that syringe, right? What was the only thing that was in that syringe?
Water.
So what do you think was in the bubbles now?
Water.
Yeah, absolutely. You got it. All right. High five. There you go. You're doing well. Okay. So inside those bubbles, there was water. And of course, like, it seems to be a gas that's in here right now. So we might describe that as being water vapor. Would you describe what you saw happening there as evaporation, boiling, or both, and why? What do you think was going on?
I don't know.
You don't know, okay. So you saw some bubbles forming here. We agree that the only thing that could have been in those bubbles was water vapor, right?
Yeah.
Where else do you see bubbles forming?
Well, I have the kettle.
Yeah? So what do you think might be the process that you
boiling.
Boiling, absolutely. So it's quite, very few people, you know, get to see the process of boiling without the introduction of heat. So if you asked a lot of young students if this was boiling or evaporation, they would say, because I'm not seeing any obvious input of heat, then there must be just evaporation but not boiling. So the demonstration that we just saw helped any students who had this idea that boiling can only take place with an obvious source of heating, like in a kettle. This demonstration helps to dispel that myth and helps them to recognize that actually boiling is more about the production of these bubbles, and that in those bubbles is water vapor. And in our next experiment, we'll take these ideas a little bit further and see what it takes to get some vaporized liquids to condense. And we'll see you then. Say bye.
Goodbye.